What's going on? Don't do anything I would. Don't do anything I would. What's going on? Bring me back something nice, huh? bring me back something nice, huh?
So, I take my first steps into damnation incarnate.
Thank you.
beast of Thunder.
Thank you. conviction drives you here. But have you thought what it might drive others to do in return?
Mistress of suffering. Judgment will not go easy on you.
We may just discover the truth of this world.
He's off to meet the Maker, is he? I'd love to be a fly on the wall of that little chat. Stay out of the shadows.
Thank you.
getting by. Good luck to you.
Wherever he is, I'm sure Tolman knows what you've done. I know you didn't do it for him, or for me. It doesn't matter. Piety's reign of cruelty is over. Thank you. See you.
Piety dies amongst her abominations, her warped dream taunting her, maddeningly out of reach. As a poet, I'm fond of that creed of justice. Here, the executioner needs recompense. Unfortunately, Piety was simply a puppet of a greater force. You've cut the strings, but the master remains. Dominus. That key you've picked up, I heard the blackguards talk of it. It's the one key to the Scepter of God on the northern edge of the blackguard encampment. Only Piety was permitted to carry it. Dominus accessed his laboratory at the summit of the tower via a pulley system rigged to the outside wall. That way will be barred to you. And I heard of no one, not even Piety, going in or coming out of the lower levels. Go with care, exile. I can't imagine what's inside that tower if even Piety and Dominus feared to tread its steps.
When Piety was experimenting on me, my consciousness was mercifully fleeting. In those moments of numbing darkness, I met a presence. Intelligence, power, immensity beyond the limits of my pitiable mortal senses. To this creature, I was but a raindrop falling into the sea. I heard Piety speak to her lackeys of the beast. It is the source of her thaumaturgy and the object of her ambitions. I believe Piety's beast and that dark entity are one and the same. Wherever it is, whatever it is,
tread carefully, exile.
You have claimed the most worthy of prey, Makoru. Piety, the mistress of corruption. I'm not saying the war is over, but you've given Rayclast a much-needed respite. Because of you, this land lives to see another dawn. And don't forget that you've done Grigor a justice of some magnitude. He will wish to speak to you. Talakura.
every stone placed for the glory of God. Beautiful. I am no beast of burden.
Still breathing, eh? Stay out of the shadows. They bite.
my dear Chittoth. The Empire has lived in fear and ignorance since its inception. Our Asmiri ancestors, in their arrogance, turned their backs on the lessons of the Vaal. The Emperors before you lacked courage, lacked vision, paying lip service to eternity while scrabbling for approval and comfort within the prison of their meager mortal lives. You are not one of those emperors. You are Chittoth the Great, the man who will make this empire truly understand the meaning of the word eternal. We shall build this thaumatocracy together.
Though we were worlds apart before, exile has brought us together. Back in Aureus, there were those that referred to me as the Wonder Child. But as you've likely discovered, titles mean little here. Wonder, exile, monster, hero. It's not the name that defines you. It's what you do that makes you what you are in Rayclast. Thank you. You have given me what matters most. The freedom to finish what I started. Though we were worlds apart before, exile has brought us together. Back in Aureus, there were those that referred to me as the Wonder Child. But as you've likely discovered, titles mean little here. Wonder, exile, monster, hero. It's not the name that defines you. It's what you do that makes you what you are in Rayclast. Thank you. You have given me what matters most. The freedom to finish what I started.
Let's go. god exile.
Genesis Dominus, and now here I stand, countless miles and wonders later, honored to be your revelation.
The summit of the Empire, not a cockroach. You have crushed the Bug Emperor and wiped his maggot dreams from the skin of Rayclast. Dominus exiled you, naked and alone, unto the palm of death. But you would not die, would you? No. No. You cuddled death, promised it the world, made it your disciple, and so generously shared it with all your fleeting friends here in Rayclast. Not once did you forget what you were. Not a cockroach feeding on the corpse of a dead empire, like the pest you crushed as you walked. A man. The sort of man that planted the seed of this empire right here in Sarn so long ago. What teetering and twisted life it still holds dear. This land owes to you, Templar. Of course, there will be more. You know that, don't you? Emperors. Avaricious little pests scrabbling to steal the legacy of their betters. Unless we burn that legacy, fear its infection from the flesh of existence. Go north, my lovely Unbug. Go to Highgate, to the beginning of the end. Dive headlong into the nightmare sea. Catch and roast yourself a nice big...
Waters wash away my sins and baptize me anew.
Bring me back something nice, huh?
What's going on?
Don't do anything I would.
What is it?
Mind.
To kill a man like Dominus, that's an accomplishment worthy of Kaum, my greatest ancestor. Were we in Na Makanui, I'd make you a Makanga, an honored warrior. But we are not in Na Makanui. We dwell in a city of death. And my respect is all the honor I can bestow on you. You have claimed the most worthy of prey, Makoru. Piety and Dominus, the harbingers of nightmare. I'm not saying the war is over, but you've given Rayclast a much-needed respite. Because of you, this land lives to see another dawn. Talakoda.